What's up, engines? Welcome back to Redemption 46 Studios. I'm Nick.
Anyong, Lonida.
I'm Keith.
I'm Curtis.
I'm Zach.
Jerick Mida.
You know the vibes. I seen the thumbnail. I seen the picture. ENHYPEN's back. Permission to dance. Tamed and dance. I haven't like watched none of this stuff. I barely have watched anything as far as live performances go with them. I did want to hear how they sound doing Permission to Dance, mm-hmm. because obviously it's a BTS song, it's they old heads, so I kind of want to hear. Yeah, I want to hear, like, I guess, like what their flair was on it and everything like that.
Okay.
This will be directly for YouTube, so if you're not on the Patreon, make sure you jump on the Patreon. We got some exclusive ENHYPEN stuff on there. By the time you're watching this, it'll be some live hotness. Performances, dance practices, relay dances, and other stuff that isn't available on YouTube. So let's jump right into this and have a conversation when we're done.
Don't stop getting. It's the thought of being young when your heart's just like a drum, beating louder with no way to guard it. When it all seems like strong, sing along to the after drum, and to that feeling we just get started. And the nights get colder, and the rhythms get you falling deeper. Just dream about that moment when you look yourself right in the eye. I think you say, I wanna dance to music's got me cooling. Nothing that can stop how we move. Yeah, let's
take a walk. I wanna hear somebody hit that note.
I do too.
Yeah. Yeah.
Here's somebody hit it with the. He stands out the most of me.
But with the blonde hair, right?
He stands out to me.
He always looking at you with just one eye. Like, crazy. Like, he be doing the side drum. Like, he smooth with it.
I like how they got Cuban links over school sweaters.
One eye.
Dog.
Right eye. That's his name, right eye.
Got some pretty smooth formations in their choreo.
This some more 80s style.
Like Stranger Things.
Huh?
Like a Stranger Things type.
The drums remind me of Blinding Lights by The Weeknd.
Yeah.
Wait till that chorus come back on.
Yeah.
I'm blinded by the lights. I can't tell me like so well. I'm blinded in the light.
Hey, I like that little leg roll.
Hey, hey. Oh, I thought he was going to do a pan in my face.
I thought he was about to give me one more time. Yeah, I'm like, damn.
I write him off if I say,
Yeah, I forget who Young Boy is. I know he's a minor group. The boy we keep talking about. Who
I just googled him. It's Nick. I don't know if I'm saying this right. Nikki.
Nikkei. Like N-I-K-I. That's his name. I just know he's the youngest. Which is funny because with TXT, I like the Imani as well too. Young Boy's killing shit. I wanted them to snap a little bit more vocally on Permission to Dance because I wanted to hear if anybody was going to hit the JK. I think the JK note.
Well, they cut it short too.
Yeah. Well, they cut it where they wanted to cut. I feel like if you wanted to show the vocal length, you could have cut it elsewhere. But I get it. You just was paying homage, and then y'all jumped right into y'all shit, which y'all killed. I love the looks.
That high school schoolboy thing is really big over there.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I guess because education is too, but I just mean like as far as like K-pop, that high school thing like look is very big. I feel like I've seen a bunch of artists do that. Like,
I feel like they'll get away with that here at some schools and shit. Like,
well, yeah, it's just not done as much here. I feel like anymore. Like it used to for sure, like definitely turn of the millennium, but over there I feel like that's like a staple. That's almost you gotta go through your high school, you know, type thing, depending on what type of group you are, of course.
Ain't nobody got school pride no more anyway.
See, if your school's shitty, maybe not. My school is the home of the champions. But
what school you go to?
Frankfurt.
When was the last time you wore Frankfurt anything?
Probably when I was on the team.
Right. Exactly.
Well, I'm not one of them niggas that still cling to my high school days.
Thank God.
So school pride is out the window.
What is when you hit a certain age? Cyber
now. I feel like everybody's on Zoom now, so it's like you really care. Like I don't really be caring no more.
He makes points.
He made a point. Zach, Kurt.
The Overbrook living rooms.
I definitely like this. I feel like it was like that second part was definitely that perfect pick-me-up music. Mm. It like puts you in a good mood. That cleaning is like, yeah, I know I can go do something now. Now I'm going to go do something. I'm going to go run. Go walk down the street. So I definitely enjoyed it. The outfits, yeah, I like those sweaters. Definitely need one. You know, Redemption went right across the chest. The number 46.
I'd rock
that'd be solid.
That's the school we represent.
That's a good color palette, too, the green and white.
Slytherin.
Slytherin.
Let us know in the comments if they sell those somewhere.
Somewhere like on Weaver.
Once you go look, that's what they're going
to
say.
You got to say everything about anything. I want to buy
the real one. I don't want to get a bootleg version.
I got the like V-Lot and Weaver's.
The Weaver's app really sell everything on
I love the
shit.
Sounds they use in that second song.
That fucking 80s drum patterns.
I feel like it's kind of becoming very popular now in pop music. It's like that the 80s.
If we be honest, it's never going away. I feel like every decade after the 80s, especially in pop music, they've used 80s synths and you know the drum sounds in every you know decade.
And if y'all like all that, make sure y'all jump on the Patreon because we're gonna be having our video up there about from the 1960s to now in pop music. So, but I was gonna double down, not to cut you off on what you said. Once you start making music that like 80s music is timeless to me. So once you stay in that timeless slot, this sounds like something that could have got played. I always say like 20 years ago or 20 years from now. You'll hear it and kind of just be like,
yeah,
probably like 40 years. At this point. So you know what I mean? Sheesh. So
that's
it's
how
just,
it was off that when the coke was raw.
But that's what it sounded like. It sounded like
why are you doing the Carlton?
It sounded like something that'd have been in the club during the Scarface movie or something.
That's why I was just like that.
Got some bops.
The 80s sound is kind of eternal, and 90s aesthetics are eternal. It's like the same thing. Like people always gonna dress like the 90s, post 90s or whatever like that. People always gonna try to make
them 80s parties. Those
I feel like 90s parties go better. Because I'm on the record of saying that early 80s for sure is like the worst dress era of all fucking time.
Yeah, it's the, it was people just finding themselves.
You think they was wearing that drip in 1870?
Man, I'll wear it with Harriet Tubman wore over to some of the shit niggas wore in 82.
I'm not gonna go that far.
Hey, man, it was simple. It matched.
This is like, look at you, it's a dirty ass cloth.
Was it too many options?
I'm not out here rocking in safety, pins and a cardigan.
Bitch, I'll smoke you with this musket.
Yeah. Niggas was rocking headbands, 1,000 safety.
Give me 10 minutes.
Give me 10 minutes.
Stay right there.
That's such a wrong.
Wait till this buckshot settle, motherfucker.
I missed.
Your
shit.
Ass is grass.
Don't move.
Yeah. Oh, don't move, boy. Hey, what you doing? Hey. Back up.
Wait.
Got my musket loaded.
Give me a quick moment.
You better not miss a drive-by in 1800s.
Well, you only fuck, spin the black back and forth. Turn the horse on.
You mean the horse? Giddy up, boy.
Sitting on the back of a horse.
Whoa, the horse.
Drop my buckshot.
The horse end up throwing you off.
Yeah. Fuck, it's the wrong end.
Boy, drop the light.
It's a scary sight.
Can you imagine boys in the light hood of 1800s?
Boys in the hood of 1800s.
It's going to be blooper reel.
Running down a dirt road and shit.
Niggas in the plantation trying to hurry up and load this. Let me stop this fucker.
Oh, man. Yeah, Kurt.
Oh my god.
The teacher.
All right. Well, the beginning of the video, I love how they pay the homage. You see the pink and purple balloons and everything, obviously. You know, Permission to Dance was, you know, a pandemic song for BTS and everything like that. So, you know, just bringing positivity and everything like that. I like that the label as a whole. I don't know if the label, like, it was like a suggestion or anything from them as far as like just kind of spreading more of that message along, you know, throughout the different groups. But I mean, I thought they did their thing perfectly on this vocally. Like, if this had just come out in and of itself, like, I would have, you know, respected it as a song and everything like that. And knowing that they're paying homage to BTS and everything like that, you could tell that, you know, it's all love, you know, between them and everything like that. Funny enough, though, I thought when the video started, and, you know, we know Permission to Dance is, like, you know, meant to be an upbeat song, you know, meant to kind of inspire and all those things. So when the video started and everything was, like, you know, really well lit and everything like that, but then it cut to, like, that blackness, and it kind of, like, I thought it was, like, a nice symbolic touch to everything, but even so, the spotlight was still on the center, so it was, like, in the midst of the darkness, you're still trying to be the bright spot, and then the kind of, the lights went wide, and then, you, like, so it was, like, I like the lighting technique of spreading that, you know, spreading that, you know, symbolic happiness and everything, but, yeah, they killed the lays and everything, the vocals. It was solid.
Keith, Jared, you talk, Jared?
I feel like I did, yeah.
I thought the video was cool. Definitely give the 80s vibe, as we already stated. Sounds like something that you would probably hear in a Scarface video while Tony doing a line. I like, honestly, and maybe this is because I've been vocal about my...
I already know what you're about to say.
I like this one better than I like Permission to Dance.
Because I was going to say it too. I was going to say they kind of ate on Permission to Dance a little bit. It's like it have been a trick. It's probably controversial.
No, I mean, well, to be fair, it's easy. Really like it's easy to elevate when you already have the blueprint.
Yeah.
Not everybody can do it though. So it's like, you know, how many times do we call Kobe the copycat of Jordan? But not everybody can even do that. So it takes a special group to be able to copy the goats. Well, they definitely killed it. And I definitely like their song. What was the second song? You know the name of that?
Tamed-Dashed.
Yeah. I like that joint. I would actually add that. No, but that was a good vibe. I like the entire video for the most part. It gives you kind of that school glee vibe. Like dancing through the halls and shit. But yeah, the Slytherin gear is cool.
Might be going on.
They too smooth them. With it.
Right.
But Euphoria tell
it. I was just about, yo, you literally took the word. I was going to say, let Euphoria tell it. Ain't nothing like this happening.
Nah, but this was good. This is a good job.
Fuck Nate.
Fuck Nate.
Okay, it must be a shout Euphoria thing.
Fuck Rude Tooth right there.
Hold on. Yeah, chill. Yeah, chill. I ain't finished that episode.
Hey, fuck Derek, too. Fuck Rue and fuck
me. Damn, I was about to hop in and say, I didn't see it either, but after you said fuck Jarek, I'm like.
That's what I mean, like, oh, shit.
Yeah, you like, oh, shit.
But y'all know the vibes, man. Like, comment, subscribe, share. Hashtag Redeemers. Let us know what other Enhyphen tracks we should react to. Definitely join the Patreon. They're going to be battling somebody at some point early on. Probably by the time this video drops, that fight should already be out. So, and if y'all want to see live performances, relay dances, and other stuff from them, all exclusive on there. But other than that, let you guys to death. Going to holler at y'all.
Cool to hear y'all.
Take care.
What Lo said.